that are separated by some 20 points in the Metro Division standings. We're off and running. Ryan Pokmara, Mitch Dunning are the referees. Devin Berg and Justin Johnson. Pullock around the horn for a Pellick wrister. That was slowed down, and Sam Stonoff will kick it away. Top of the screen, you're about to see Peter Laviolette's line combinations and defense pairings. Caps led a 3-1 lead. Wriggle off the hook in the third. Isle stepping in. Palmieri, beautiful moves to his backhand. He scores a highlight reel goal.
That was a wicked dipsy do to get around Jensen. Left defenseman coming one-on-one at him at full speed. There's the slip of the skate, and he lost an edge to Jensen. He blew a wheel, and that allowed Palmieri to get inside. There's Jensen. He wipes out, coming across, didn't keep him wide, got to the inside, and then it's all stick work. What a deke around the goaltender, his teammate, and the goaltender at the end of this to make it 1-0 Islanders.
The Capitals had scored the game's first goal.
Washington is challenging that there was goaltender interference prior to the scoring of the goal.
And they think that it might have knocked the stick out of his hand.
The question here is, does Zach Parise prevent Samsonov from doing his job? It's Parise in front of the goal.
Video review, it was determined that there was goaltender interference. We have no goal on the play.
Western New York or the Sabres. We're talking Rangers and Islanders.
Yeah, we are.
On the outside, Orlov turns, skips a man for Jensen, bumps for a long-range drive, score! Deflection in front, Caps grab the lead.
Deflection on a high tip. Look at Connoisseri move away from the net, gets the end of his stick on it, and then it's a bouncing biscuit. And the bouncing biscuit, goalie's worst enemy. There's no way he can be set up for the puck from going down, then back up. A rubber ball goal for Connoisseri. It's 1-0 Capitals.
19 on the season for Sherry. On the move, Isles get the zone. Palmieri back for Pullock. Looking to Bailey. It came all the way through. Great kick-out save there. Samsonov a beauty on Bailey. Barzal dealing into the zone. Palmieri coming late. Snapshot block. Follow-up chance. Point blank. Samsonov to the splits there on Bellows.
Games when Sammy's in the net losing his stick. Here he is scrambling. It actually got caught up. And he got ran over by his forward, Kuznetsov, who lost his stick at the other end. So they're playing down a hockey stick in front.
Snapshot off the crossbar. Rattles around and out. 25 seconds in the man advantage. Pullock drives and scores. A laser beam.
And Kuzi's complaining to the referee and linesman. He had his stick ripped out of his hands at the other end. And when he was back-checking, he was on stick. Couldn't readjust playing with three. Look at Kuzi at the top. He can't get out there. And there's that slapper through a maze past the blocker. What a slapper from Pullock. He's got a couple of guys available. Calls his own number. And got his fifth of the season from downtown. They're going for it. They're D all over the place, especially on the attack. That Pullock shot, the guy trying to get the rebound off Samsonov was his partner Pellick. So they're playing a little wide open game here in the first.
Van Riemsdyk fires. That one rattles around off the frame and out of play.
The D have the majority of them. It's hard to get to the forwards to get the puck. There's the shot.
I thought
Thank
it was great
you.
Again.
Did you like that Obi was escorting you on
yes,
the ice?
I saw him do that.
I said, oh my God, I feel like I'm 90.
As the aisles clear, it's Martin through center, a two-on-two developing. J.G. Pageau back to Martin in tight, and Samsonov with a nice pad stop.
That's the best save of the period and best save of the game for Ilya. What a save with the right toe.
Yep, we're blessed to always have great, good goaltending, and we draft well and develop well, and it's been good to see both kids get a chance, and we'll see you. He's really great, and Ferravari, I think, is way underrated by some. He's really had a great season as well.
Palmieri stopped there by Samsonov, who's slow to get back up to his skates.
First season, played in the bubble, the playoffs, the end of the season, the playoffs, and then last year was different, right?
Yeah, it
some
was.
With fans, without fans, and this year's starting to feel a little bit more normal. I'm sure the playoffs will be.
Well, when you have a slap shot like John does, you can rent it.
Yeah.
My slap shot wouldn't get me any time there. Rotation play off of Carlson's skate, kicked out.
Caps get another opportunity. Hard work down low, outnumbering them down low. The second chance.
Locker, I am sure of one answer, and I'm guessing between the other two guys for the one other spot. Dobson and Barzell playing catch around Jensen. Barzell sweeps it down low to Pageot. Pageot getting the lion's share of the faceoff duties tonight. Great kickout stop by Samsonov on Lee. Pageot hits the brakes. Barzell drifting below the goal line. Matthew Barzell from a sharp angle. Bailey. Then Dobson on Korsman. He scores.
Well, they were in the zone the whole time. Maybe one clear, a buck 23 of zone time. Coming into this period, half the shots between both teams, 50% of them were from the D. He gets a lucky bounce right off the body of TVR. And look at TVR's expression at the end of this. This was 2 feet wide, and it hits him right in the kneecap and goes right past the startled goalie, Samsonov. And absolutely nothing. He doesn't lose at their new arena.
Turnover. McMichael, 2-on-1 with Kuznetsov. McMichael fires. Sorokin the save. Rebound loose. And Sorokin made the follow-up stop on Schultz. Well defended by Pulock. And it's cleared on down by Dobson.
Man, that's one of the best pairs in the NHL. Pulock and Pellick.
Look out. Cizikas from his wallet. He scores. A fantastic effort from Casey Cizikas.
That is a hard-working goal. He's in double digits. He's got 10 goals now while he's on his wallet. Watch this play behind the net. There's the mishandle, the misexchange. He wipes out, and then he spins it on the backhand off the pipe and past Samsonov. That is a gritty, grindy goal that Cizikas just demonstrated, and it gives the Islanders a 3-1 lead. That baby's shorthanded.
First special teams goal of the season for Cizikas, his first 9. Dowd advancing with Larson, cross ice off the boots of Hathaway. Nick Dowd to the corner, Hathaway on his backhand, snapshot Larson, covered up there, rebound loose in front of Sorokin, and the whistle comes with the puck in plain sight for us, but not for the referee. The Islanders all of a sudden with a 2-goal lead to protect, and Ilya Sorokin hanging on. Jensen, another stub pass. Kiefer bellows from the severe angle. Low bridge the referee. Pulock drops the hammer. That was blocked. Down in the heat goes Wilson. Lee rockets one to the top corner. It's 4-1.
And I think Wilson was looking for a trip on that far side from Barzell. He wiped out because he got tangled up with the legs of Barzell. This is where I thought there'd be a penalty on Barzell. Right there, he cut in front, took away the lane. He picks up the puck and gets to it along with Lee. He'll probably get an assist on that play because he caused the turnover and touched the puck. Maybe he didn't touch the puck. This could be unassisted because the puck is whacked right to Lee, who puts it under the bar, catching glove side.
The Cizikas shorthanded goal was unassisted. 4 unanswered for New York overall. 3 in succession in a 13-minute spell of the third. The Islanders are cruising. Palmieri's in again. Pad save by Samsonov. Had to have that one. A sock trick.
I've never heard of that.
Backhand here. Great stop by Sorokin on Oshie. Just on the toe of his pads. The 8 teams in the Eastern Conference playoffs are set. The matchups, sooner than later, the math will take over. With the playoffs expected to begin Monday and Tuesday of next week, the Islanders will congratulate Ilya Sorokin. They've ended.